I'm delighted to be speaking with Richard Woodward again. Hello, Richard.
Thanks for having me back.
Pleasure. Now, we're talking about strategy today and how to run an effective strategy planning session, whether you're working on your own or whether you're in a company. So how do we go about it? What are some tips for us?
Well, I think there are various tips, if you like, for ensuring that you have a successful session. I think the first is the format of the session. I think it's important not just to look forward, but also to review the past. So what I mean by that is, if you're going to do a plan for the year ahead, take the time before you do that to review the learnings from the previous year by asking yourself some fundamental questions around, in that time period, what worked, what did I feel good about, what didn't I feel good about, and what were the barriers for achieving the goals.
Okay. And so always start with a bit of a review before you start looking
forward. Because what you're really looking for are the learnings to take forward into the new session, if you like, the new time period. And ultimately what we're all looking for is, what's that point of difference that's going to make the difference in the year ahead? And it could be just typically one or two things that are the key factors that are going to drive the success of the next year's plan. So it's about looking in the past, looking in the future in terms of the format. I think the second thing is about how you capture the information. And when we're running workshops for people, what we always do is make sure we capture the information visually. Okay.
Right.
So it's putting up around the room, typically with kind of different colored cards and stickers to capture the positive and negative and the thoughts, etc. And the reason for doing that is, one, it's very important to capture every thought.
Yep.
Two, at the end of the day, you see you've done a hell of a lot of thinking.
Right.
Three, everyone in the room has if there's more than one person, has an equal input. If you just keep the conversation verbal, it can be dominated by one person, maybe a more senior person. But if you allow everyone to participate and capturing the information visually, then everyone has an equal say. Everyone's point is equally as relevant.
So when you've kind of started like this and you say you've got all your ideas out there, how do you then, is that what you're coming on to next? How do we then kind of distill that down to something usable?
Yeah, well, this is the beauty of these sessions, because of a planning session where you capture the information visually. Because if you ask a question such as, okay, as a group, let's highlight now what we see as the 10 key problem areas in our business. If you get everyone to put that information up visually, you can get that information in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
If you sit around talking about it, you could be all day kind of trying to distill out that information. That's the beauty of capturing information visually and having a record of it. The key then is to ask yourself, what are the key issues? Getting people to prioritize and then addressing, ultimately, what are the important issues moving forward? Because there's no point addressing the 10th most important issue when you should be doing the 1, 2, and 3.
Focus on the most important one.
Yeah, because ultimately it's all about, what are you going to do differently? Because in our businesses, the businesses will repeat the same patterns day in, day out. That's fine.
Yeah.
Our businesses exist. Our organizations exist. What is the point of difference that's going to make the difference moving forward is the real crucial thing.
And the third point?
Well, I think the third point really is about preparation.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is, people say to me, you know, can you run a planning day for us or whatever? The key is not about turning up and delivering the planning day. The key is preparing the planning day. So if you're thinking of having a planning session, you should think about 50% preparation, 50% in essence delivery. And in that preparation, what you really want to do is have a clear articulation, quarter hour by quarter hour, hour by hour, of the whole day, of the whole session, in terms of what are the questions you're going to ask, how are you going to capture that information, and also sometimes to think through what might be some of the answers to see if that's the kind of information that you'd be looking to generate. So that you walk into the day, whether it's your own planning session or whether it's in a group planning session, with a really focused, tight
agenda
yeah, okay. Which at the end of it is going to generate some really key outcomes to drive
and
your organization
forward. And in a business, let's say the case of a small business,
how
often would you say we need to be having a strategy session?
Well, this is the very good point.
That's the million-dollar question, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the thing is, there is the opportunity to review every interaction. So every meeting you go to, every phone call you make, every presentation, every proposal, there is a chance to debrief that experience. But really, I think effectively, something like every 3 months, getting together with yourself saying, in the previous 3 months, I had these goals, I had these objectives, what worked, what didn't work, what do I need to do differently?
What do I need to do more of?
Exactly.
Okay.
What's the difference that will make the difference?
Okay. Terrific. Richard, thanks very much for joining us again. I know if we need more information from you, we go to www.richardwoodward.com.au.
You certainly do.
Great. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.